family Mar Denzel. I want to tell you that the Almighty God will always mourn with the broken hearted and will bind their wounds. May the Almighty God give you the strength to overcome the untimely demise of our brother Denzel. It is quite unfortunate that he had to go too soon, but the Almighty God has his plans. In the book of 1 Peter 5:7, the Bible says that casting all your anxieties on him because he cares for you. May you take all your challenges, the mourning, the discomfort to the Almighty God, for he's the only person who shall free you from this, who shall give you comfort. For blessed are those who mourn, the Almighty God shall comfort with them. Secondly, I would like to talk about Denzel's journey briefly. Denzel comes from this village, Kanjira village. Denzel's parents did all they could to educate Denzel. From nursery school, to primary school, to secondary school, and now to university. They sold all they had. They sold the parcels of land they had to educate Denzel. They sold all the cows they had to educate Denzel. They toiled and moiled to educate Denzel, only for Ruto to return Denzel in a coffin. It is so unfortunate. It is so saddening. It is so cantankerous. It is so belligerent. It is so obnoxious. And it is causing discomfiture, discombobulation of spirits. Shame on you, Ruto. Shame on you, Ruto. Shame on you, Ruto. We are mourning the death of our brother who was butchered, who was slaughtered. Denzel's face can't be recognized in a coffin because he was thrown in a quarry. You told us that you will stop the Rivayala killings. You've started the quarry killings. Ruto, instead of organizing this country, you are antagonizing this country. And you are an enemy of the people. And therefore, as comrades, we will always condole with the family. We are there as your sons, as your children. I want to really thank the comrades from JQAT and other comrades from other universities. Thank you so much for standing in solidarity with one of our own. Thank you so much for holding demonstrations to search for the answers for those who killed Denzel. And we know the greatest killer, who is both vicariously liable and directly liable for the death of Denzel, is Ruto. He's the one who has taken the life of this young man sleeping there. But the Almighty God will always revenge for us. Next, to the Gen Z's in this country, you are making us proud. We love you. We love what you are doing. We know the difference between Gen Z's and Ruto. The first difference, as the Gen Z's are leaderless, Ruto is rudderless. As the Gen Z's are leaderless, Ruto is rudderless. As the Gen Z's are tribeless, Ruto is heartless. As the Gen Z's are tribeless, Ruto is heartless. As the Gen Z's are faceless, Ruto is Ruto is use. We have to use him less because he's hostis humani generis, hostile to the human mankind. He is the enemy of the people, and he will forever remain the enemy of the people. As Ruto, as the Gen Z's are fearless, Ruto is care? as the Gen Zs are formless, Ruto is mannerless. And therefore, all the negative less belongs to Ruto. We cannot come here today to bury a young man like Denzel. It is Denzel who should be burying the parents, not the parents burying Denzel. And therefore, as comrades, we know that tomorrow we have a date with destiny. And for something good to happen, something must break. For something good to happen, something must break. For a seed to germinate, the ground must break. For it to rain, the sky must break. For a child to be born, water must break. For a child to be born, water must. For Kenyans to get development, Ruto must. Ruto must. For Kenyans to get justice for all those who have been killed, Ruto must. Let us deal with the head. Let us deal with the head. Koome watu waneza msalamia popote penye yupo. So that tuna ensure asiteme popote. Because we will not allow the deaths of our young men and women, the death of Denzel, to go without justice. We must stand for our comrades. We must fight for our comrades. And you cannot intimidate us day and night. I didn't expect this from Ruto, a person who said that he sold eggs and sold chicken for him to get school fees. A person who promised hustlers that he will get them from bottom to up. He said that a mama mboga will graduate from selling mboga in a kiosk to owning a supermarket. Is there any person here who has a supermarket? He told us that a boda-boda rider will graduate from riding a boda-boda to buying a matatu. Is there anybody with a matatu here? Therefore, Ruto must? For Ruto to dialogue with the Gen Zs, number one, he must resurrect all those that he have killed. All the comrades who have been killed in this nation must be resurrected by Ruto. Compensation is not enough. You cannot exchange the life of a person just with money. So compensation should be an obvious thing. We should not demand for it. Because we cannot keep on losing our young people. When you are rejected, when you are a father in a house and you've been rejected by the children in that house, please just commit suicide. Just commit suicide. Because children should love their parents. Children should love their fathers. And if a father is not loved by a child, then it means that you are doing everything in the wrong way possible. We cannot negotiate with Ruto when he's bringing back Duale, who released military in the streets to kill our Gen Zs, to kill our people. We cannot negotiate with Ruto, who has returned Kindiki, who should be in Hague, ICC, a person who gave orders for our children to be killed. We cannot negotiate with Ruto, who allowed these other CSs called Chirchir. I can't even remember him because he's used. We cannot negotiate with him, with a person who allowed Chirchir to come back, a person who has a scandal of 17 billion Kenya shillings. How many jobs can 17 billion Kenya shillings give to our young men and women in this country. We cannot negotiate with a person who was involved in a fertilizer scandal. Then Ruto is taking his PA and putting as a minister for water. Ujinga si ujinga. Ufala si ufala. We cannot negotiate with a person who has been taken, I don't know from where, who was a deputy aspirant in a gubernatorial seat. A person who does not know the definition of education to come and be a minister for Jamani. Where are we headed as a nation? Then we are being told to negotiate, and if you don't negotiate, then you should not belong. We are ready not to belong. But we are ready to stand up for the rights of our young men and women. When I look at these comrades, I see myself who struggled to go to school because I lacked fee at some point. Right now, Ruto has introduced a new funding model for the university students. How do you expect a parent who is seated here, mama ambaye ameketi hapa, mtoto wako amepita, anaenda university, kisha unaambiwa ya kwamba ile pesa iliyo chini ambayo inafaa ulipie mwanafunzi ni 300,000 Kenya shillings. Wewe mama unauza changa kama mamangu. Wewe mama unauza mboga kama wa mama wengine. Unauza omena. Wewe baba unaenda bodaboda, unaendesha. Baba anaenda mchengo, unalimia watu. Ujawahi shika shilingi 1,500 ama 10,000 kwa mkono hivi. Unashika tu 200, 600, ikienda mingi 1,000. Utapata 300,000 Kenya shillings wapi every year? Na uko na watoto watatu, wanne, watano wa kuelimisha. Ujinga si ujinga. Kama mtoto anaenda kufanya medical course, unaambiwa ni 600,000 Kenya shillings. Utapeleka mtoto wapi? Na huyo ndiye mtoto ambaye ulikuwa unamtegemea, kama vile Denzel wa parents wake, wazazi wake wanamtegea. Wanamtegemea kama mtoto ambaye aliyekuwa firstborn. Ili waje akishamaliza university, apate kazi, atoe wazazi kwenye hapa village, atoe wazazi kwenye mamitaa. Alafu unatuongezea elimu iwe juu. Wewe ni mtu ambaye una nia nzuri ama una nia mbaya. Kisha unatutisha. Wana sisi hatuwezi kutishwa. Sisi, mimi kama babu nisha enjoy everything nilikuwa nataka ni enjoy maishani. Everything. Saizi chenye menibakia ni kupigania haki ya watu wangu. Kwa hivyo uwezi nitisha na kifo, na uwezi nitisha na maneno ya jela. Kama ni jela, nimelala huko. Kama ni cell, nimelala mara kadhaa. Hakuna police station yote kule Nairobi ambayo sijai lala huko. Saizi wamemaliza za Nairobi, sasa walikuwa nanipeleka za nje. Leo hii, venye nilikuwa nakuja hapa, nimetumiwa message na DCI. Nisaidie na hiyo simu niwasomee hii message. Anatuma barua, na hivi ndivyo barua inavyosema. Powers to compel attendance to police station / police officer under section 52 subsection 1 of the National Police Service Act 2011 of general functions, powers, organizations and rights of public officers in the service. I, Eunice Mjue, na wewe Eunice, usitumiwe. Usitumiwe. Mimi ni yule mbegu mbaya sana. Usitumiwe. I, Eunice Mjue, rank of Chief Inspector, attached to DCI Nairobi County Headquarters, police station, and inquiring into an alleged offense of incitement and money laundering. Nilikuwa na launder pesa mamako ama nani? Section 96 of the Penal Code, where I do believe Honorable Babu Owino, na amesahau jina doctor, address me appropriately. is involved or has information which can assist me in my investigations under the powers conferred to me under this section, I request you, Honorable, wacha niongeze, Dr. Babu Owino, to report to me at DCI Nairobi County Headquarters, Police Station, today, on the 24th day of July, 2024, at 9 o'clock, and furnish me with full information concerning the case. Am I the one to help you investigate my case, or you should investigate the case? Huyu anakili ama anakili, jamani? Ruto anakili ama ana? So it's me to help them investigate myself. Bore sana. Note that failure to comply with the above requirement renders you liable for prosecution. I've had so many cases in court. This one is gibberish. This one is balderdash. This one is nothing. It cannot intimidate me. And lastly, if you will continue intimidating people, Ruto, you are the person who should be in charge at the International Criminal Court because of crimes against humanity. You've killed people. You've forcefully evicted people in Nairobi. You were charged even with rape sometime back. But now you want to intimidate us with police stations in Kenya. In a prison, there is free accommodation. Why should we fear? In a prison, there is free food. Why should we fear? In a prison, you don't pay rent. Why should we fear? In a prison, if you are sick, you are taken to the hospital for free. Why should you fear? Shame on you, Ruto. Shame on you, Ruto. Mimi nataka niwashukuru sana. Kesho. Kesho ni kesho, asemai leo ni? Kesho ni kesho, asemai leo ni? Vijana ria. Gen Z tiagas. Warembo ha. Wamama mne. Kanisa tialala. Asanteni sana, Mungu awabariki. Asanteni. Sasa. Asante, asante. Sasa.